Welcome to the ThinkCell Tutorials. The ThinkCell library gives you access to slide templates, icons, stock images, and your own slide and image assets, all directly within PowerPoint. If you're stuck staring at a blank slide and wondering where to begin, the ThinkCell library has 250 slide templates to inspire you. This video shows you how to search for slide templates, how to add a template to your presentation, and how to customize the slide in your presentation. To get started, we'll open the ThinkCell library. In PowerPoint, go to the Insert tab and select Library. In your list of library sources, select Slide Templates. If you don't see slide templates in the source list, you might be able to add them in the library's configuration mode. For more information, see our user manual section on adding slide templates to the library. As you can see, there are many kinds of templates to choose from. There are templates for agendas, SWOT analyses, project planning, and more. Let's say you want to find a template for visualizing a process. In the search box, enter Process. In the search results, you'll see templates that, either in the slide text or the file name, contain the word process. Slide text that matches the search term is highlighted in yellow. You might want to zoom in on a slide and see it in more detail before deciding to insert it. To resize the slide thumbnails, hold Ctrl and rotate the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. On a touchpad, pinch and stretch. If you want to use a template that has a ThinkCell chart, select ThinkCell Charts. Here's a template with a bar chart and a comment box. ThinkCell inserts the new slide directly after your current slide. If you first click between two slides, the new slide appears there instead. To insert the slide template, click the thumbnail once, then close the library. As you can see, the slide has adapted to this presentation's style and formatting. Instead of the green color theme and the font set to Arial, we now have the office color theme and the font set to Garamond. The slide templates automatically update to match your slide master and layouts, making it easy to maintain visual consistency across your presentations. Now you can customize the slide however you'd like. Let's update the chart data. In this example, we'll double-click the chart to open its datasheet and manually enter the data. If you want to link your chart to data in Excel, see our tutorial on Excel data links. As you can see, the chart annotations are all still there and are updated to match the new data. For more information on chart annotations, see our video tutorial. Finally, we'll update the slide text. Let's make the title more descriptive. We'll also add some relevant information in the comments. And that's it for this tutorial on slide templates. You can also build presentations with other kinds of library content. For example, stock images and icons, or slides and images from your own computer. To learn more, see our other library tutorials.